everybody, Zero Fossil Fuel. I just wanted to show you with the return of some warm weather, it's finally time to get back out here in the garage and start building again. These are some plates that I've had in storage all winter long that I wanted to put together, and this is by far, or will be by far, my most ambitious build for a brute force electrolyzer cell series design. Fashioned after the tall vertical cell that I have in use right now, but the one that I have in use right now has 304 grade stainless steel plates. These are 316, courtesy of Turtle. So thank you very much, Turtle, for these. I'm finally putting them to use, as you can see, and I wanted to show you. I've learned a few shortcuts with the construction techniques of putting these together. I have a few of the plates already separated with tie wraps. I've taken the heads and cut the heads off of all the tie wraps so that they don't interfere with each other as I slide them in between the plates. What I do is I just take my knife and I separate one of the plates. Incidentally, there's already an elastic band that runs around the height of the plates, holding them together this way so that I can slide the tie wraps in between them from the sides. I'm just going to take this and lay it in, pull the knife out, and then push it in the rest of the way. I do a few of these like this, then I flip the block over, and then I do a few more on the other side to even it out. And when I'm done, I will take a small ruler and I'll just nudge these tie wraps in about 1/8 of an inch to 1/4 of an inch deep into the openings, so that I can then take acrylic panels that have Goop marine adhesive smeared over them about 1/16 of an inch deep, and just compress it onto the edges of the plate stack, and that will force the glue down in between the grooves, but it won't actually force it down far enough to come into contact with the tie wraps. The tie wraps are there just to keep it spaced while the adhesive cures, and then I'll take it and flip it over and repeat the process on the other side. And I'll have a complete plate stack separated with the acrylic panels, and a nice sealed column for the convection current to flow up through the bottom of the cell. Alright, that's it for this little tip. Hopefully this goes together pretty smooth. This is obviously the same construction technique that I used for these smaller type cells, experimental. But I have been anxious to put these and get them wet. They are 316L, and this is a 5 neutral plate design with 5 electrodes. So each of these electrodes is positive. The two bottom electrodes will be negative, and there will be 6 intervening spaces between each electrode, which should give me approximately 2.3 volts between each plate when the cell is in solution. That's it for now, Zero Fossil Fuel. Okay, after reviewing the last clip, I noticed that the new headset that I was trying has a loud hum on it. I apologize for that, but I will not be re-recording that video just because there was a hum on the audio. So for those of you who might be inclined to complain about such trivia matters, forget it. Okay, it stays. Sorry about that. We'll move on. I wanted to show you, I'm just going to finish putting together this stack with the spacers. Bring these over here. Get a chance to demonstrate to you one of the problems that I run into as I did this, and learn from my mistakes so that you don't have to repeat them. All right. This cell stack is very heavy. This is quite a bit of stainless steel. So when I go to lift it, you have to pinch it very tightly and also support it from the edge like this underneath, because the plates have a tendency to slide by one another and the tie wraps pop out. So just set it back down there like that. And I'm going to finish up this side. And I have one extra tie wrap. Looks like I miscounted. Oh well. And that's it. All of the plates are evenly spaced with the tie wraps at 45 thousandths of an inch. Although I have a feeling that they might be a little bit wider at the top than they are at the bottom, so I'm going to measure. See, we've got 2 3/8 there and 2 1/4 there. Okay. All right, folks, I don't know if you can see this, but I'm going to tell you it's having an impact. And when you stack up 24 of these along the plates, you can't see this, but there's a little bit of a text imprint on the tie wrap. And I'm going to have to take these tie wraps and push them up so that the text imprints extend above the cell between the plates so that I get a perfectly even spacing going vertically. That tiny, tiny bit of raised plastic added up all the way across, added up to almost 1/4 inch. How do you like that? Okay, 15 minutes later, and I have almost all of the tie wraps shifted upward. You see, I just lift it out of the groove, slide it up so that the raised text feature on the tie wrap, or I should say nylon cable tie, let's not use tie wrap because that's a trademark, and I'm not actually using the tie wrap trademarked cable ties. Okay, now I will take a measurement. We have 2 5/16 and 2 5/16 all the way down. Okay, that's good. So the gauge of my steel plus the thickness of all these nylon cable ties gives me a total plate stack height of 2 5/16 inches. I'm going to square this off. Just make sure that all the plates are nice and even. Shift it that way. Okay, so now all the plates are straight up and down this way. And I know that they are even this way. They're not skewed that way at all either. They're nice and even. Like so. So the next step is going to be to take my ruler, which is my box of tools, and I'll just take my thumb and hold it at about maybe 3/16 inch and push all of the tie wraps down in, all of the cable ties down in between the plates, to a depth of 3/16 inch, nice and even. And I'll cut my acrylic panels to be exactly, let me think. Yes, I want the acrylic panels to be exactly 2 5/16 this way. And then they will also overhang maybe another 1/2 inch down below here so that I can rest it at the bottom of the container that I set this into, and it will be self-supporting off the bottom of the container to allow the convection flow to go up through the cell. And because it will be the exact height, my end panels will extend and overlap the edge panels, like so. And I'll put a bead of marine adhesive along this edge so that it clamps the whole assembly together and holds it, even if there is the possibility that the plates become unadhered to the adhesive which is holding them spaced properly, and chances are very good that they will. So that's the reason that I do that. All right. I guess that completes this phase of the assembly. Now I need to push all these down and take my saber saw and cut some acrylic panels and spread out the goop and lay them in there, and I'll show you that in the next step. Very quickly, I just want to show you the technique that I've settled on for setting the cable ties in between the plates. I'm just taking the graduated edge of this steel rule, and I found it easier to just take it and lay it on top of the edge of the tie wrap or the cable tie, excuse me, and just set it down to the correct depth like that and move on to the next one. You may have to start at one end just to get the steel rule to start down in between the plates. But that's how that's done. Okay, all of the cable ties have been set to the correct depth. All I did was take my two thumbs, and determine where I wanted it, where it'd be a good place, and just repeated that all the way down the line. I do want to point out, however, one little thing that I noticed. Because of the way the elastic bands are wrapped around the length of the plates, and the clamping force is only at the extreme ends, there is a slight amount of flex in the middle of the plates where the center of the plates have bowed out slightly like this, so that when I take my acrylic panels with the goop on it and set it down for the adhesive to dry, I will also make sure that there is some clamping force in the middle to take up that little bit of flex so that I end up with perfectly parallel plates going all the way up, compressed against the tie wraps. Okay then, this is where it really starts to come together. I've got my goop marine adhesive. I have the first panel that I'm going to assemble to the edges. It'll be on the bottom. I'll rest the plates on top of it. And I'm going to spread it thin with my ruler, and I'll just peel it off after it dries later. Okay? So you can also see I've got a couple of wooden blocks to keep the center plates compressed. All right, there's no flex there anymore. It's exactly even all the way down. Put this aside for just a second. Carefully. And then, hopefully I don't get in the way so I can show you this. I'm going to run few beads of the marine adhesive like that. And I'm just going to take the ruler and spread it nice and even. And that is just about 1/16 of an inch thick, which is what I'm after. And I'm going to bring this all the way to the edge, because this will be the top edge of the plates. The bottom edge of the plates, remember, will only come to about here, about a half an inch from the end of the edge panels here. That's about as good as I'm going to get it. So I'll take that, pick this up, and carefully drop it into place. I will slide it around just a little bit to center it. And I gotta say, that looks pretty darn good right there. Alright. Let me just pick it up. That's nice and even with the top edges. And I'll take a look down inside, and I can see as I look lengthwise up through the cell that the adhesive has squeezed in between the plates, going up the edge of the cell just a little bit more than 1/16 of an inch. I'll say 3/32, but it is not all the way up to the tie wraps or the cable ties, so that it will not stick to the cable ties, and I'll be able to slide those out when I'm done. But that's it. That's this phase of the assembly. I'm going to let it dry overnight, and then I will take this whole block, flip it upside down, do the next panel exactly the same way, smear the goop, set it in there, let it dry, and then I'll be able to take the whole thing apart and put a couple of end panels to seal off the outer edge plates and give it even more rigidity. Zero fossil fuel, that'll do it for today. Well, folks, there it is. It is the completed cell brick. You have no idea how bad I want to get this thing wet. But unfortunately, it's been the adhesive has been curing for 2 days, and I still smell very strong solvent coming out of the adhesive from between the plates. So there's no way I can get this wet, but I just wanted to show you how it's coming out. And we're going to go in close here. I want to show you this feature. Right here, this plate is a baffle plate that I created that seals off the edges of the plates, an additional half an inch of the edge of the plate, so that across the top there is only 1 inch of exposed plate. Right here is a notch that was cut with my saber saw against the openings of my workbench here, so that it didn't break the plastic, because there's just a very thin strip of plastic that holds this thing together as one piece. And I assembled it the same way I did with the side panels, in that I layered the Goop Marine adhesive on it first, slid the plate into place, and then just laid it down on top of the stainless steel to squeeze in between the plates and set up right there. So really coming along nice, but unfortunately it still smells very strong after 2 days, and I cannot get this thing wet until it is fully cured. So it may be another day or two before I can actually do that. So, in light of that, I decided that I would get to work on the electrolyzer body. This is a piece of 4-inch inside diameter white PVC, and Home Depot sells this in 24-inch sections, so it makes a perfect tube to build as the electrolyzer cell. This is a 4-inch screw-on clean-out cap. Here is the collar that will screw into. Alright. And this, unfortunately, is the bottom of the cell, and they do not come flat, they come convex. I wish they came flat, but they're supposed to be able to hold back pressure, and because of that, they don't make them flat. They only make them slightly curved like that. So, however I affix this in the vehicle, it's going to have to be secured from the side. Now, I don't know how well this comes across on camera, but what I've done is, because it's 24 inches, and when I took my cell and determined how deep I was going to let this thing sit, the bottom cap will sit like that, alright? So I'll probably be about an inch off the bottom. My electrode straps come up to about here. I'm going to run some stainless steel threading through the positives and through the negatives and extend them up just enough to complete the electrical connection underneath the cleanout cap. So if I assemble all of this together and sort of hold it in place how it will sit, I decided that 12 inches is exactly the height that I need for the tube, plus the length of the collar and the bottom cap will give me the correct height for the cell, and I'll be able to make two complete units out of this tube. If this design happens to work out well enough. So what I'm going to do is, with my tape measure, I've measured off exactly 12 inches and made marks all the way around. And now I'm going to just take a stiff tie wrap like this, wrap it around, and complete my mark with the Sharpie. And once I get that onto the plastic, I connect three dots so that I know that it's straight, and I'll just keep going around like that. Incidentally, it doesn't have to be absolutely perfect, because again, the end caps will be glued to it, and the clean-out cap collar will be glued to this, so perfect edge is not necessary. So there's my mark. There's my line. What I'll do is take a hacksaw and just cut my first opening into it, and then I'll take my electric saber saw and just go all the way around the groove and cut this out to two 12-inch lengths. Alright, I've decided that the material cuts easily enough that I can just spin it in the vise and continue my way around, so I'm going to continue and just finish it off with the hacksaw rather then getting my electric saber saw off of the shelf and messing around with that. I'm actually able to follow that line pretty well, so I'm going to continue like that and finish it off this way. Okay, I've spun it about 5 or 6 times and made a little bit of a cut there. I'm going to finish it off. There you have it. Two 12-inch pieces. I've taken my pocket knife and I've cleaned up the edges of the ends of the tubes from all the burrs that were created when I used the hacksaw. And it is a very straight edge. I'm pleasantly surprised with the way this came out. Now, if you were to use this in a situation where you were going to put flat end plates on it and make a compression fitting, compression fit against this, then you could always just take a piece of sandpaper and put this against the sandpaper and spin it in rotation to get this surface perfectly flat, as well as to create grooves, concentric grooves in the edge of the PVC so that it created a much better seal against whatever gasket material that you use against the tube. But like I said, I'm just going to be taking this and gluing it in place, right, with some PVC cement along here so that it doesn't squeeze into the cavity of the cell chamber itself for both the collar with the clean-out cap and for the bottom end cap. My neighbor across the street kindly donated some PVC cement a while back when I ran out, and these pipes are large enough. I don't know how much of this stuff I'm going to end up using that he gave me, but thank you, neighbor. There's quite a bit left here. But just to show you how we're going to do this, load up the wad here, make a wad like that. Just go around a few times. Now as I compress this into place, it'll push the adhesive up the side of the tube, but it won't get inside the cell itself. That looks good there. Ah, it smells good. Yeah. Sorry. Former life. I don't know how well you can see this, but inside the top lip of the pipe came right up to the stop for the collar, which is exactly what I wanted. So this will take a little while to dry too, but it will sit in the tube like this. There will be plenty of space above the plate assembly, above the plate brick, for the any bubbles to burst and settle out, so that what exits the electrolyzer chamber is pure gas. Hopefully, we want to limit the amount of actual fluid that escapes this in the form of bubbles. So I've allowed for quite a bit of space. At the top, there will also be a blowout safety device to relieve any pressure should a backfire occur and actually get back into the cell. It is very unlikely, but got to be careful. So we'll be taking all the precautions here. And so this is the completed unit. If I take the cap off, what will happen is, however I decide to attach this to the electrodes on the outside, they will be suspended from the cleanout cap, and the whole thing will just screw in as one assembly down into the opening of the tube. Like so. Okay, getting back to the cell itself, the plate brick for a moment. You can see I have taken and laid it flat against the bench, and I've taken some pieces of some scrap pieces of acrylic and 3/4 inch thick pine board to make this rigid so that it gives me a stiff surface to drill down against. Now I'm going to drill first a pilot hole in the top strap, and I'm going to then complete it all the way down through the remaining straps so that my threaded rod can go down and attach the electrodes. Oh, much better. Now I will finish out the diameter of that hole with the 1/4 inch drill bit. Created the first hole. Now the remaining ones will simply be aligned by making a dimple on the next plate down with the 1/4 inch bit that will give me a locator for my pilot hole. And now I'll just complete the holes all the way through, do that for both sides, create my threaded rods to go through, and attach it with bolts and hanger straps that go to the clean out cap at the top of the cell. That's all there is to it. There we go. So I'll drill my pilot hole, and I can see that as I create the pilot hole, my drill bit is centered down through the 1/4 inch holes that it extends through. So that's a good thing. It sounds like my battery's gonna die. Figures. Whatever. At least I got the pilot hole drilled through. And then I'll just finish the hole going through the other way, and they should line up reasonably well where I can take my threaded rod and just go right through and clamp them, bolt them all together. I'll show the completed assembly in just a minute. Okay, I just want to show you the threaded rod assemblies and the nuts that I've assembled through the ends of the electrode extender bars. Alright, and at the top now I'm just going to bend one over this way, and I'll bend this one over the other way, and they will align laterally across the top of the cell so that I can suspend it from the top and it will hang straight inside the cell. The other point I wanted to make is this: when you're drilling the holes, I had this standing vertically. Make sure that's all on the camera. Yeah, I had this standing vertically, and I was deburring the holes after I had drilled them, and I thought, oh my god, dummy, a couple of chips fell inside the plates, and with gap spacing this close, that could have been disaster. And fortunately I was able to blow it out with compressed air, and there are no short circuits in here. So when you're deburring the holes, leave it sideways like that. Take it from somebody who learned the hard way. And in just a minute, hopefully I'll have this assembled to the clean out cap and show it to you being assembled inside the cell body. I've pretty much decided about how far I had to spread the electrode bars, the drop down electrode bars, across the top, so that they will span the width of the inside of the cleanout cap when I assemble it, make the final assembly here. Now, if I were to just bend these over straight, I would end up with angled mating surfaces to the bottom here. So what I need to do is I need to bend this over such in such a way that they mate flush or flat with the bottom surface of the inside of the cleanout cap, so that when I tighten it down, I get a good airtight seal. And the way I'm going to do that is just take a piece of plexiglass here as a straight edge, and then I'm going to mark a line going across the two electrodes down far enough where, after I bend it, I can drill my holes for the bolts that'll go through, and I'll describe the lines and bend it according to those lines. After I bend it, if I were to bend this one, for instance, it's going to angle outward this way even further, and I'm going to have to probably do some trimming along this back edge after I fold it over, so that it will then fit underneath the cap to be bolted. And I'll take and put the holes here and here far enough away from the square nut on the top of the cleanout cap so that the wing nuts won't interfere. I've clamped it in the vise at the angle that I've drawn on the edge of the band, and I'm just going to take it now with a hammer, make sure it's good and tight in the vise so it doesn't shift. And I'm going to bend it flat at the angle that I want it. And now I shift it off to the side, and I end up with the wings that I was after when I first started this whole project. Even that first time in the vise was not enough to get it exactly right the first time, so I did have to tweak it just a little bit. But after tweaking it, take a straight edge and lay it across, and you can see now that it is perpendicular to the vertical axis of the cell. And now I know when I hang it into the tube, it's going to hang straight underneath the cap. I'm very pleased with that result. And I'll show you one other thing I am very pleased with. That is a perfect fit. There is not even a 1/16 of an inch. So I'll be drilling my holes now through the tabs that are bent over close to the corner, the outside corners, as I can get them without sacrificing the integrity of the metal. Okay, here I've got the tabs drilled out on both ends, and I'm just going to take these pre-drilled openings in the tabs, set them underneath the cleanout cap, and I'm going to use the holes to actually locate where I'm going to be drilling the holes through the cleanout cap. Just mark them with the black Sharpie, like so. Okay, and there are my marks that I'll be drilling. Okay, I finished my pilot holes, and now I'm going to drill my quarter-inch holes. And you got to be careful because the drill bit grabs into the PVC very easily with the pilot holes. You can see it cranked my wrist. Now, I've been asked about how I seal the end caps, get a good seal on my bolts, and I want to show you the bottom of the heads of these bolts. You'll notice that they're smooth surface, and when I send these up through the drilled holes in the flat bend stainless steel and compress that against the underside of the cleanout cap, it's really just smooth surface against smooth surface under a compression fitting that provides the seal that I need to keep the gases in the cell. And it's really all that's required. You don't need glues or O-rings or anything like that. All I need to do now is send the 1 1/4 inch stainless steel bolts up through the straps, assemble the cleanout cap over the bolts lining up the holes, like so, and put a couple of flat washers against the PVC to keep it from getting damaged when I put the lock washers on top of that. The split lock washers do two things. They hold the nuts in place, and they also keep pressure, a constant pressure, on the PVC plastic. So if the plastic softens a little bit, the split locks will
open up a tiny bit and keep the pressure on the plastic. All right, going to just tighten up the nuts on the power terminals coming through the PVC with my adjustable wrench here. And I'll assemble the wing nuts to show that I've got plenty of clearance between that and the square drive at the top of the cleanout cap. Okay. Now you'll notice it hangs nice and straight. And I'm going to show you the canister that I've made. It just slips down inside like that, and the whole thing assembles as one piece. It will be about an inch from the bottom of the canister. Now right here we're going to drill for the gas outlet, and on the top we're going to have a blowout so that in case the in case there's ever an explosion backfiring into the cell, it will relieve the pressure. Now I'm going to create a level indicator the same way I did on the bubbler, and they'll have a sight tube along the side to show me the fluid level inside the electrolyzer cell. Top of the plate brick is about here, and I want the water level to be just underneath the collar so that the plate brick is always fully submerged in solution when it's in the car, in the vehicle. And here is the plate brick completely assembled to the cleanout cap. I'd like to ask everyone if they see anything missing from this picture. Look at it real close. What do you see that I should have put on here that didn't? That I didn't. I was in a real hurry to get this thing together, and I forgot the heat shrink tubing on the power straps going down to the brick. So what does that mean? It means to take the whole damn thing apart and put it back together again, this time with the heat shrink on the terminal straps going down to the plate brick. Isn't that fun? Okay, here we are about 45 minutes to an hour later, and I now have the heat shrink tubing assembled to the power straps going down to the plate brick so that it insulates the terminals from the solution and concentrates the voltage on the plates where I want it. The sight tube is now complete on the side of the electrolyzer cavity. I've drilled a couple of holes in the sides of the collar and of the bottom end cap, tapped it and drilled it and tapped it for the threaded angle fittings, barbed fittings for the pipe, and assembled the tube, which will show the level indicator, and it's exactly like I constructed for the bubbler. Okay, when the unit is fully assembled, the top of the cap will be even with the top edge of the collar, and the top edge of the plate will be at about this location on the tube, and I'll want the water level to be right about here so that I know that the plate brick is fully submerged in the electrolyte at all times. Also, the electrolyzer brick will sit about 1 inch off the floor of the... All right, a couple of points I want to mention is that a couple of people on YouTube recommended that I use primer before applying the PVC cement and assembling the components of the tubes. It's probably a good idea. The consequence of that is that the adhesive inside, deep inside here, will take much longer to cure than it otherwise would with the primer. I don't believe that mechanical integrity is a very large factor here, so I'm not going to worry about it too much. I also wanted to point out that I'm taking a suggestion from another user. I've taken the electrode bolts that were originally just going through the straps and the corner of the strap right up against the bottom surface of the PVC, and then the top nut to secure everything together. The problem with that is if there's any heating that takes place at this connection, it will soften the PVC and loosen the connection even further. So what I've done is I've taken that out of the equation by putting a bolt with a nut and a lock washer on it and socking that down really tight so that this can't loosen up over time. This is metal to metal, and then it also gives me the option now of putting a nut on the bolt so that I can level the cap, or level the plates hanging down underneath the cap a little bit better. So that gives me a little bit more adjustment, and I can also adjust the depth inside the cell. And this is actually a little bit closer to where I want it, which will get even closer to the bottom of the tank. So also, I'm going to be drilling with a hole saw a hole right in the very top of this cap. And I stopped at Home Depot today. I picked up a 1-inch PVC end cap and a 1-inch PVC fitting that goes inside the end cap. And what I'll do is, when I create the hole in the top of the cap, I'm going to send this through from the bottom and glue it into place. And then I'm going to cut the top of the cap off. When I cut the top of the cap off, it's just going to be a ring that slips down over this piece of tubing that protrudes from the top. And I'll just take a piece of cellophane, set it over the top, and push this down on top of that, and that will create my blowout. As well as, I can just pull it off, take the cellophane off, and use this as my filling tube. So hopefully I'll have all of this together in a short while to show you. I'm very happy with the progress so far. I just recently had the eyeball calibrated, so I should be fairly close tolerance here. That before I break it. Oh, that will do very nicely. Okay, that's seated all the way down. The adhesive has squeezed out a little bit. I've got none on the outside over here, which is a good thing. I don't really want it there. So there you have it. The filler cap. Put the cellophane on top of that. I'm going to lop this off, so I'll just make a ring, and it'll push down, seal it up, create a blowout. Well, boys and girls, there it is. It is the completed vertical series plate brute force VSPB cell.
There's the top of the cell. You can see the positive battery terminal here, negative on the other side. I have my barbed outlet fitting. It's a quarter NPT barbed outlet fitting. I'm hoping that won't be big enough. I'm hoping to have to go to 3/8 or half inch on that. So wishful thinking. Here is the completed blowout assembly. Okay, this just is a fairly loose fit on top of this piece of pipe. I did shave off a little bit around this outer corner to make this a loose, slightly looser fit. And then practically any piece of plastic that you stretch over the top of this and push this over top of will create a nice tight drum inside there. You get a look. Okay. Saran wrap will probably work well. Plastic sandwich bag. Practically any piece of plastic that you can find laying around will make an excellent blowout for that. So in case we ever get a flashback into the cell, that should easily relieve the pressure. And that, as they say, is that. Buddy Zero Fossil Fuel. I just wanted to show you with the return of some warm weather, it's finally time to get back out here in the garage and start building again. These are some plates that I've had in storage all winter long that I wanted to put together, and this is by far, or will be by far, my most ambitious build for a brute force electrolyzer cell series design. Fashioned after the tall vertical cell that I have in use right now, but the one that I have in use right now has 304 grade stainless steel plates. These are 316, courtesy of Turtle. So thank you very much, Turtle, for these. I'm finally putting them to use, as you can see. And I wanted to show you, I've learned a few shortcuts with the construction techniques of putting these together. I have a few of the plates already separated with tie wraps. I've taken the heads and cut the heads off of all the tie wraps so that they don't interfere with each other as I slide them in between the plates. What I do is I just take my knife and I separate one of the plates. Incidentally, there's already an elastic band that runs around the height of the plates, holding them together this way so that I can slide the tie wraps in between them from the sides. I'm just going to take this and lay it in, pull the knife out, and then push it in the rest of the way. I do a few of these like this, then I flip the block over, and then I do a few more on the other side to even it out. And when I'm done, I will take a small ruler and I'll just nudge these tie wraps in about 1/8 of an inch to 1/4 of an inch deep into the openings, so that I can then take acrylic panels that have Goop marine adhesive smeared over them about 1/16 of an inch deep, and just compress it onto the edges of the plate stack, and that will force the glue down in between the grooves, but it won't actually force it down far enough to come into contact with the tie wraps. The tie wraps are there just to keep it spaced while the adhesive cures, and then I'll take it and flip it over and repeat the process on the other side, and I'll have a complete plate stack separated with the acrylic panels and a nice sealed column for the convection current to flow up through the bottom of the cell. All right, that's it for this little tip. Hopefully this goes together pretty smooth. This is obviously the same construction technique that I used for these smaller type cells, experimental. But I have been anxious to put these and get them wet. They are 316L, and this is a 5-neutral plate design with 5 electrodes. So each of these electrodes is positive. The two bottom electrodes will be negative, and there will be 6 intervening spaces between each electrode, which should give me approximately 2.3 volts between each plate when the cell is in solution. That's it for now, zero fossil fuel. Okay, after reviewing the last clip, I noticed that the new headset that I was trying has a loud hum on it. I apologize for that, but I will not be re-recording that video just because there was a hum on the audio. So for those of you who might be inclined to complain about such trivia matters, forget it. Okay? It stays. Sorry about that. We'll move on. I wanted to show you, I'm just going to finish putting together this stack with the spacers. Bring these over here. And I'll get a chance to demonstrate to you one of the problems that I run into as I did this and learn from my mistakes so that you don't have to repeat them. This cell stack is very heavy. This is quite a bit of stainless steel. So when I go to lift it, you have to pinch it very tightly and also support it from the edge like this underneath, because the plates have a tendency to slide by one another and the tie wraps pop out. So just set it back down there like that. And I'm going to finish up this side. And I have one extra tie wrap. Looks like I miscounted. Oh well. And that's it. All of the plates are evenly spaced with the tie wraps at 45 thousandths of an inch. Although I have a feeling that they might be a little bit wider at the top than they are at the bottom, so I'm going to measure. See, we've got 2 3/8 there and 2 1/4 there. Okay. All right, folks, I don't know if you can see this, but I'm going to tell you it's having an impact. And when you stack up 24 of these along the plates, you can't see this, but there's a little bit of a text imprint on the tie wrap. And I'm going to have to take these tie wraps and push them up so that the text imprints extend above the cell between the plates, so that I get a perfectly even spacing going vertically. That tiny, tiny bit of raised plastic added up all the way across, added up to almost 1/4 inch. How do you like that? Okay, 15 minutes later, and I have almost all of the tie wraps shifted upward. You see, I just lift it out of the groove, slide it up so that the raised text feature on the tie wrap, or I should say nylon cable tie, let's not use tie wrap because that's a trademark, and I'm not actually using the tie wrap trademarked cable ties. Okay. Now I'll take a measurement. We have 2 5/16 and 2 5/16 all the way down. Okay, that's good. So the gauge of my steel plus the thickness of all these nylon cable ties gives me a total plate stack height of 2 5/16 inches. I'm going to square this in a situation where you were going to put flat end plates on it and make a compression fitting, compression fit against this. Then you could always just take a piece of sandpaper and put this against the sandpaper and spin it in rotation to get this surface perfectly flat, as well as to create grooves, concentric grooves, in the edge of the PVC so that it created a much better seal against whatever gasket material that you use against the tube. But like I said, I'm just going to be taking this and gluing it in place, right, with some PVC cement along here so that it doesn't squeeze into the cavity of the cell chamber itself, for both the collar with the clean out cap and for the bottom end cap. My neighbor across the street kindly donated some PVC cement a while back when I ran out, and these pipes are large enough. I don't know how much of this stuff I'm going to end up using that he gave me, but thank you, neighbor. There's quite a bit left here. But just to show you how we're going to do this, load up the wad here, make a wad like that. Just go around a few times. Now as I compress this into place, it'll push the adhesive up the side of the tube, but it won't get inside the cell itself. That looks good there. Ah, smells good. Yeah. Sorry. Former life. I don't know how well you can see this, but inside the top lip of the pipe came right up to the stop for the collar, which is exactly what I wanted. So this will take a little while to dry too, but it will sit in the tube like this. There will be plenty of space above the plate assembly, above the plate brick, for any bubbles to burst and settle out, so that what exits the electrolyzer chamber is pure gas. Hopefully, we want to limit the amount of actual fluid that escapes this in the form of bubbles, so I've allowed for quite a bit of space. At the top there will also be a blowout safety device to relieve any pressure should a backfire occur and actually get back into the cell. It is very unlikely, but got to be careful, so we'll be taking all the precautions here. And so, this is the completed unit. If I take the cap off, what will happen is, however I decide to attach this to the electrodes on the outside, they will be suspended from the cleanout cap, and the whole thing will just screw in as one assembly down into the opening of the tube. Like so. Okay, getting back to the cell itself, the plate brick for a moment. You can see I have taken and laid it flat against the bench, and I've taken some pieces of some scrap pieces of acrylic and 3/4 inch thick pine board to make this rigid so that it gives me a stiff surface to drill down against. Now I'm going to drill first a pilot hole in the top strap, And I'm going to then complete it all the way down through the remaining straps so that my threaded rod can go down and attach the electrodes. Oh, much better. Now I will finish out the diameter of that hole with the quarter inch drill bit. There you have it. I've created the first hole. Now the remaining ones will simply be aligned by making a dimple on the next plate down with the quarter inch bit that will give me a locator for my pilot hole. And now I'll just complete the holes all the way through, do that for both sides. Create my threaded rods to go through and attach it with bolts and hanger straps that go to the clean out cap at the top of the cell. That's all there is to it. There we go. So I'll drill my pilot hole, and I can see that as I create the pilot hole, my drill bit is centered down through the quarter inch holes that it extends through. So that's a good thing. It sounds like my battery's gonna die. Figures. Whatever. At least I got the pilot hole drilled through. And then I'll just finish the hole going through the other way, and they should line up reasonably well where I can take my threaded rod and just go right through and clamp them, bolt them all together. I'll show the completed assembly in just a minute. Okay, I just want to show you the threaded rod assemblies and the nuts that I've assembled through the ends of the electrode extender bars. Alright, and at the top now I'm just going to bend one over this way, and I'll bend this one over the other way, and they will align laterally across the top of the cell so that I can suspend it from the top and it will hang straight inside the cell. The other point I wanted to make is this: when you're drilling the holes, I had this standing vertically. Make sure that's all on the camera. Yeah, I had this standing vertically, and I was deburring the holes after I had drilled them, and I thought, oh my god, dummy, a couple of chips fell inside the plates, and with gap spacing this close, that could have been disaster. And fortunately I was able to blow it out with compressed air, and there are no short circuits in here. So when you're deburring the holes, leave it sideways like that. Take it from somebody who learned the hard way. And in just a minute, hopefully I'll have this assembled to the clean out cap and show it to you being assembled inside the cell body. I've pretty much decided about how far I had to spread the electrode bar, that the adhesive has squeezed in between the plates going up the edge of the cell just a little bit more than a 16th of an inch. I'll say 3/32, but it is not all the way up to the tie wraps or the cable ties, so that it will not stick to the cable ties, and I'll be able to slide those out when I'm done. But that's it. That's this phase of the assembly. I'm going to let it dry overnight, and then I will take this whole block, flip it upside down, do the next panel exactly the same way, smear the goop, set it in there, let it dry, and then I'll be able to take the whole thing apart and put a couple of end panels to seal off the outer edge plates and give it even more rigidity. Zero fossil fuel, that'll do it for today. Well, folks, there it is. It is the completed cell brick. You have no idea how bad I want to get this thing wet, but unfortunately, it's been the adhesive has been curing for 2 days, and I still smell very strong solvent coming out of the adhesive from between the plates. So there's no way I can get this wet, but I just wanted to show you how it's coming out. And we're going to go in close here. I want to show you this feature. Right here, this plate is a baffle plate that I created that seals off the edges of the plates, an additional half an inch of the edge of the plate, so that and across the top there is only 1 inch of exposed plate. Right here is a notch that was cut with my saber saw against the openings of my workbench here so that it didn't break the plastic, because there's just a very thin strip of plastic that holds this thing together as one piece. And I assembled it the same way I did with the side panels, in that I layered the Goop Marine adhesive on it first, slid the plate into place, and they just laid it down on top of the stainless steel to squeeze in between the plates and set up right there. So really coming along nice, but unfortunately it still smells very strong after 2 days, and I cannot get this thing wet until it is fully cured. So it may be another day or two before I can actually do that. So in light of that, I decided that I would get to work on the electrolyzer body. This is a piece of 4-inch inside diameter white PVC, and Home Depot sells this in 24-inch sections, so it makes a perfect tube to build as the electrolyzer cell. This is a 4-inch screw-on clean-out cap. Here is the collar that will screw into. All right, and this unfortunately is the bottom of the cell, and they do not come flat, they come convex. I wish they came flat, but they're supposed to be able to hold back pressure, and because of that they don't make them flat, they only make them slightly curved like that. So however I affix this in the vehicle, it's going to have to be secured from the side. Now I don't know how well this comes across on camera, but what I've done is, because it's 24 inches, and when I took my cell and determine how deep I was going to let this thing sit, the bottom cap will sit like that. All right, so I'll probably be about an inch off the bottom. My electrode straps come up to about here. I'm going to run some stainless steel threading through the positives and through the negatives and extend them up just enough to complete the electrical connection underneath the cleanout cap. So if I assemble all of this together and sort of hold it in place how it will sit, I decided that 12 inches is exactly the height that I need for the tube, plus the length of the collar and the bottom cap will give me the correct height for the cell, and I'll be able to make two complete units out of this tube if this design happens to work out well enough. So what I'm going to do is, with my tape measure, I've measured off exactly 12 inches and made marks all the way around. And now I'm going to just take a stiff tie wrap like this, wrap it around, and complete my mark with the Sharpie. And once I get that onto the plastic, I connect three dots so that I know that it's straight. And I'll just keep going around like that. Incidentally, it doesn't have to be absolutely perfect because, again, the end caps will be glued to it and the clean-out cap collar will be glued to this. So, perfect edge is not necessary. So there's my mark. Here's my line. What I'll do is take a hacksaw and just cut my first opening into it, and then I'll take my electric saber saw and just go all the way around the groove and cut this out to 12 inch lengths. Alright, I've decided that the material cuts easily enough that I can just spin it in the vise and continue my way around, so I'm going to continue and just finish it off with the hacksaw rather than getting my electric saber saw off of the shelf and messing around with that. I'm actually able to follow that line pretty well, so I'm going to continue like that and finish it off this way. Okay, I've spun it about 5 or 6 times and made a little bit of a cut there. I'm going to finish it off. There you have it. Two 12-inch pieces. I've taken my pocket knife and I've cleaned up the edges of the ends of the tubes from all the burrs that were created when I used the hacksaw. And it is a very straight edge. I'm pleasantly surprised with the way this came out. Now, if you were to use the drop-down electrode bars across the top so that they will span the width of the inside of the clean-out cap when I assemble it, make the final assembly here. Now, if I were to just bend these over straight, I would end up with angled mating surfaces to the bottom here. So what I need to do is I need to bend this over in such a way that they mate flush or flat with the bottom surface of the inside of the clean-out cap so that when I tighten it down, I get a good airtight seal. And the way I'm going to do that is just take a piece of plexiglass here as a straight edge, and then I'm going to mark a line going across the two electrodes down far enough where after I bend it, I can drill my holes for the bolts that'll go through, and I'll describe the lines and bend it according to those lines. After I bend it, if I were to bend this one, for instance, it's going to angle outward this way even further. And I'm going to have to probably do some trimming along this back edge after I fold it over so that it will then fit underneath the cap to be bolted. And I'll take and put the holes here and here far enough away from the square nut on the top of the clean-out cap so that the wing nuts won't interfere. I've clamped it in the vise at the angle that I've drawn on the edge of the band, and I'm just going to take it now with a hammer, make sure it's good and tight in the vise so it doesn't shift. And I'm going to bend it flat at the angle that I wanted. And now I shift it off to the side, and I end up with the wings that I was after when I first started this whole project. Even that first time in the vise was not enough to get it exactly right the first time. So I did have to tweak it just a little bit. But after tweaking it, take a straight edge and lay it across, and you can see now that it is perpendicular to the vertical axis of the cell. And now I know when I hang it into the tube, it's going to hang straight underneath the cap. I'm very pleased with that result. And I'll show you one other thing I am very pleased with. That is a perfect, perfect fit. There is not even a 1/16 of an inch. So I'll be drilling my holes now through the tabs that are bent over close to the corner, the outside corners, as I can get them, without sacrificing the integrity of the metal.
Okay, here I've got the tabs drilled out on both ends, and I'm just going to take these pre-drilled openings in the tabs, set them underneath the clean-out cap, and I'm going to use the holes to actually locate where I'm going to be drilling the holes through the clean-out cap. Just mark them with the black Sharpie, like so. Okay, and there are my marks that I'll be drilling. Okay, I finished my pilot holes, and now I'm going to drill my quarter-inch holes. And you got to be careful because the drill bit grabs into the PVC very easily with the pilot holes. You can see it cranked my wrist. Now, I've been asked about how I seal the end caps, get a good seal on my bolts, and I want to show you the bottom of the heads of these bolts. You'll notice that they're smooth surface, and when I send these up through the drilled holes and the flat bend stainless steel and compress that against the underside of the cleanout cap, it's really just smooth surface against smooth surface under a compression fitting that provides the seal that I need to keep the gases in the cell. And it's really all that's required. You don't need glues or O-rings or anything like that. All I need to do now is send the 1 1/4 inch stainless steel bolts up through the straps, assemble the cleanout cap over the bolts, lining up the holes, like so, and put a couple of flat washers against the PVC to keep it from getting damaged when I put the lock washers on top of that. The split lock washers do two things. They hold the nuts in place, and they also keep pressure, a constant pressure, on the PVC plastic. So if the plastic softens a little bit, the split locks will open up a tiny bit and keep the pressure on the plastic. All right, going to just tighten up the nuts on the power terminals coming through the PVC with my adjustable wrench here. And I'll assemble the wing nuts to show that I've got plenty of clearance between that and the square drive at the top of the cleanout cap. Okay. Now you'll notice it hangs nice and straight. And I'm going to show you the canister that I've made. It just slips down inside like that, and the whole thing assembles as one piece. It will be about an inch from the bottom of the canister. Now right here we're going to drill for the gas outlet, and on the top we're going to have a blowout so that in case there's ever an explosion backfiring into the cell, it will relieve the pressure. Now I'm going to create a level indicator the same way I did on the bubbler, and they'll have a sight tube along the side to show me the fluid level inside the electrolyzer cell. The top of the plate brick is about here, and I want the water level to be just underneath the collar so that the plate brake is always fully submerged in solution when it's in the car, in the vehicle. And here is the plate brick completely assembled to the clean out cap. I'd like to ask everyone if they see anything missing from this picture. Look at it real close. What do you see that I should have put on here that I didn't? I was in a real hurry to get this thing together, and I forgot the heat shrink tubing on the power straps going down to the brick. So what does that mean? It means to take the whole damn thing apart and put it back together again, this time with the heat shrink on the terminal straps going down to the plate brick. Isn't that fun? Okay, here we are about 45 minutes to an hour later, and I now have the heat shrink tubing assembled to the power straps going down to the plate brick so that it insulates the terminals from the solution and concentrates the voltage on the plates where I want it. The sight tube is now complete on the side of the electrolyzer cavity. I've drilled a couple of holes off just to make sure that all the plates are nice and even. Shift it that way. Okay, so now all the plates are straight up and down this way, and I know that they are even this way. They're not skewed that way at all either. They're nice and even. Like so. So the next step is going to be to take my ruler, which is in my box of tools, and I'll just take my thumb and hold it at about maybe 3/16 of an inch and push all of the tie wraps down in, all of the cable ties down in between the plates to a depth of 3/16 of an inch, nice and even. And I'll cut my acrylic panels to be exactly, yes, I want the acrylic panels to be exactly 2 5/16 this way, and then they will also overhang maybe another half an inch down below here so that I can rest it at the bottom of the container that I set this into, and it will be self-supporting off the bottom of the container to allow the convection flow to go up through the cell. And because it will be the exact height, my end panels will extend and overlap the edge panels, like so. And I'll put a bead of marine adhesive along this edge so that it clamps the whole assembly together and holds it, even if there is the possibility that the plates become unadhered to the adhesive which is holding them spaced properly, and chances are very good that they will. So that's the reason that I do that. All right, I guess that completes this phase of the assembly. Now I need to push all these down and take my saber saw and cut some acrylic panels and spread out the goop and lay them in there, and I'll show you that in the next step. Very quickly, I just want to show you the technique that I've settled on for setting the cable ties in between the plates. I'm just taking the graduated edge of this steel rule, and I found it easier to just take it and lay it on top of the edge of the tie wrap or the cable tie, and just set it down to the correct depth like that and move on to the next one. You may have to start at one end just to get the
steel rule to start down in between the plates. But that's how that's done. Okay, all of the cable ties have been set to the correct depth. All I did was take my two thumbs, and determine where I wanted it, where it'd be a good place, and just repeated that all the way down the line. I do want to point out, however, one little thing that I noticed. Because of the way the elastic bands are wrapped around the length of the plates and the clamping force is only at the extreme ends, there is a slight amount of flex in the middle of the plates where the center of the plates have bowed out slightly like this. So that when I take my acrylic panels with the goop on it and set it down for the adhesive to dry, I will also make sure that there is some clamping force in the middle to take up that little bit of flex so that I end up with perfectly parallel plates going all the way up, compressed against the tie wraps. Okay then, this is where it really starts to come together. I've got my Goop Marine adhesive. I have the first panel that I'm going to assemble to the edges. It'll be on the bottom. I'll rest the plates on top of it. And I'm going to spread it thin with my ruler, and I'll just peel it off after it dries later. Okay? So you can also see I've got a couple of wooden blocks to keep the center plates compressed. All right, there's no flex there anymore. It's exactly even all the way down. Put this aside for just a second. Carefully. And then, hopefully I don't get in the way so I can show you this. I'm going to run a few beads of the marine adhesive like that. And I'm just going to take the ruler and spread it nice and even. It is just about 1/16 of an inch thick, which is what I'm after. And I'm going to bring this all the way to the edge, because this will be the top edge of the plates. The bottom edge of the plates, remember, will only come to about here, about a half an inch from the end of the edge panels here. That's about as good as I'm going to get it. So I'll take that, pick this up, and carefully drop it into place. I will slide it around just a little bit to center it. And I gotta say, that looks pretty darn good right there. Alright, let me just pick it up. That's nice and even with the top edges. take a look down inside, and I can see as I look lengthwise up through the cell,